Welcome back to Unstitched with Rich and Anton.
What's going on, everybody? Welcome to the next installment of Unstitched. And this week, we'll be debating. I said debating.
All right, yeah. You can start over. Just right. Go ahead.
Yeah. What's going on, everybody? Welcome to the next installment of Unstitched. This week, we'll be debating laces versus loafers. I'm not going to tell you my position yet, but let's go right to Rich and see where he is on this topic.
Man, if you guys don't know, I'm a big fan of loafers, loafers of all kinds. So let's dive in, bro. What you got on the laces? That's old man style. Go ahead.
First off, laces are classic. This is probably one of your lines, but they can go in. Yeah, they can go anywhere at any time, right? So you have a laced shoe. You can wear it with jeans. We can do it with a suit. Laces, you can't go wrong with it. A loafer, I'm going to save my remarks for the loafer where you generally see loafers. But, you know, tell me where you are.
Well, I know what you're saying. But to me, the loafer adds a little bit of element of casual elegance, if you will.
Okay.
Also, it's a little more streamlined, and I'm gonna save another point for later, but the streamlined look is why I like it. It gives you a, like I said, a real elegant finish. Kind of, you think European style. A lot of guys in Italy big on the loafers. Soft leather. That's one of the biggest reasons I like it.
Now, see, and the problem I have is when I think loafers, I think velvet and crests on the toe, like, you know what I'm saying? And that and that's kind of like where I am with it, like, because in my mind I'm thinking, all right, velvet jacket, pipe, and I'm not even talking not cigar, but like, I mean pipe, like, you know, Thurston Howell the Third type situation. Like, that's what I'm thinking with loafers. Like, even one of our clients hit us over the weekend asking about loafers versus laces for a black tie, and you know what everybody chose? Lace ups.
Yeah. That's where they made a mistake. Should have went with the loafers. The thing about the loafers is there's so many different style of loafers too. Think about it. Tassel, no tassel. Like you said, slippers, penny loafers. And then the different finishes. You can get a loafer with all suede. You can go with animal print. Switch up the style gives you more versatility. Sometimes to me, when you lace up, it looks like, you know, you're going to the office ready to punch a clock. With the loafer, I can transition from working in a upscale environment and then switch it and go casual when I'm ready to hit the bar scene after work or just go out with friends. Take off the tie. I still got the loafers. I can even do that with a double-breasted suit, man. It's versatile.
But tell me, you going to the office with your tiger stripe loafers on? So like tell me. Like, you say animal print. Let me, that's what we're doing?
The animal print will be reserved for another time. But for a nice classic leather loafer,
right,
brown or black with a tassel, very appropriate. Can even be considered classic, if you will, and good for many professions where you have to be pretty conservative. Wouldn't you agree? I got you. Go on. Just agree.
It's like, no, I can't agree with that. Like, to me, the only thing that loafers are basically slippers with class. Like, that's all they really are. I remember back in the day, my mother sent me to school with some penny loafers, like burgundy joints. You know exactly the ones I'm talking about, with the penny on it. Michael Jackson-esque, right? You know what happened to me?
Ladies were choosing. Yeah, probably.
No, dudes were bruising. Like, it was not a good situation, bro. So we're not doing the loafer situation. If you go with the lace-ups, and I mean, you got to know. The lace-ups come in so many different varieties, styles,
they do.
Colors. Like, with the loafers, I really feel like a lot of guys that wear loafers are really trying. Like, they're reaching. They're not doing it organically. It's just like, you know what? Let me go out here and spend $250 on these velvet loafers with the crest on the top.
With going the two to the lions, velvet with the crest.
With the two lions like this.
That's not the only kind of loafers there are, man.
But that's what loafers invoke. Like, I mean, that's what it looks. That's what it is. And granted, I can't front. We've done something really good with some loafers recently.
Hold up.
Yeah. I mean, I get it. But
we're the people at the event going crazy or not over the loafers with the tassel.
Facts. They were.
They were. Okay, there you go. So the people have spoken. Last point for me. Comfort. Comfort level. I can slip in. I slip out. Easy to break in. Easy to walk around in all day. And here's the one. This is the finisher. This is like Mortal Kombat. Finish him. Loafers. I can wear them with shorts. You can't say the same thing with your stiff, tough, hard to break in lace-up shoes.
First of all, we're going away, everybody, soon. So I'm going to bring some lace-ups, and I'll have pictures to prove it. I'm going to keep the receipts. But
lace-up sneakers? We're not talking about sneakers.
No, I'm talking about...
Some wingtips?
No, just wait, everybody. Rich going to wait. Everybody going to see. Everybody going to see. All right. This is my thing. If you got to be out, if you got to go, can that happen in loafers? No. No,
no, no, that's a whole different show.
Listen, we have to always be ready for whatever we need to be ready for. And loafers are really what they are for loafing around. If it goes down, casual, guess what?
Elegance.
Yeah, yeah, you're going to be casual, like casually where you are. You know what I'm saying? Listen, everybody, you see where I stand on this situation with the loafers. You see where Richie is. Let us know. Rich, take everybody home.
All right, guys, we're really divided on this one. So vote below. Let us know. Loafers or lace-ups? Let's see who wins this one. Good battle.
This was Unstitched.